going on, everybody? Thank you so much for coming back to another video. And in today's video, we're going to be talking about Dolittle. So Dolittle stars Robert Downey Jr. as Dr. Dolittle. Of course, we got those films with Eddie Murphy back in the day, and I believe it's based on a book, but I've never read those books. I've only ever grew up watching the Eddie Murphy films, and I loved those first two films as a kid. I haven't watched them in many years, so I feel like I can't really speak to how good they actually truly are, but I have a lot of fond memories, and I was really excited for this film leading up to it. I really, really enjoyed the previews. Something about it was really calling to me. I loved the way it looked aesthetically. Visually, it just really called to me 100%, and on top of that, I love Robert Downey Jr. and I was really excited to see what they would do with this film. Now going into watching it today, I was a little bit nervous, mainly because the reviews that came out from the critics gave it like a 13% on Rotten Tomatoes, but then I had a little bit of hope in me because I saw the audience score was around 70 something, so I was hoping that it wasn't nearly as bad as the critics were saying. And after having seen it, I could say with a smile on my face that I enjoyed it. I thought it was a good time. It was nothing crazy, and I think I need to stress that 100%. This is 100% a kid's film. This film is 100% made for families and for kids. It is not necessarily made for people of my age or older. It's a very silly, over-the-top kids movie that goes on this whimsical adventure with talking animals and all kinds of silliness. It does not dive deep into a lot of the characters. There are a lot of side characters that kind of have rushed development or lack of development altogether. The villain is very one-note, and you don't really feel like you're connected to too much as far as the overall story, but the adventure that these characters go on, specifically Dolittle and these animals, are the things that I found myself most connected to, and I found it to be a silly, fun watch. It's nothing crazy, not something I would tell you guys to go rush to theaters to go watch, but I had a good time with it. I think I was really able to just enjoy the whimsical approach to this character that Robert Downey Jr. brought to the character. You know, it's just weird and fun and crazy to see him playing a role so different after him playing Iron Man for such a long time. It's a very different role for him. I think it was a good choice for him to kind of just do something completely different. My only gripes would be that I wish that the script was a lot stronger. Here you kind of have a weak script. It's not very, very strong as far as really expanding on a story. The film feels very quickly paced. You know, the movie ended fairly quickly for me. I feel like in a lot of those cases where things feel like they're moving by really quickly, you don't have a lot of time with the characters to really develop them. And I think that was the biggest issue I had with this film. There's nobody that you ever really feel attached to or in love with, but I was really into him as Dolittle. I think he did a good job of playing off of the backstory that they set his character up with and making you emotionally feel for him and understanding his approach and how he gets in and out of situations. I don't think it's a crazy movie by any stretch of the imagination. I don't think it's something that's really gonna blow people's minds, but I think it's gonna do really well with kids and families. And in the theaters that I was in, there was two women sitting one seat away from me that were having a huge laugh watching this film. They were definitely enjoying it. There was definitely plenty of moments that I was at least smiling or smirking or laughing at a few moments. It wasn't anything over the top. There were plenty of jokes that landed flat for me that just didn't do it for me and that were more on the silly kid side. There's fart jokes, there's poop jokes, there's all that kind of stuff. This is 100% a kid's movie. And I can't stress that enough because seeing the critics' response to it and them kind of dogging on it for being a kid's movie and almost being too much of a kid's movie is kind of the basic gist I'm getting from a lot of critics. I just don't feel like that's a really valid criticism. Like, I get it. We can make really smart kids movies that are work for adults and for kids. But a lot of times, it's okay to just have a kid's silly movie that does not take itself very seriously. And I think that's what you have here with Dolittle. I think the visual effects were really well done. Of course, it really just depends on what you want out of visual effects. As somebody who's loves CGI in films and embraces CGI, I liked the way that the film looked. There was a very colorful, vibrant look to the film. The animals looked very photorealistic at times while also maintaining this very over-the-top cartoony sense to the characters and to the world because it is a big cartoon. Even the character of Dolittle is just a live-action cartoon in this film. And that's something that I definitely, again, I have to stress that this is a big kids movie. Like, this is just a big budget kids movie. I had a lot of fun with it. I really enjoyed it for what it was. I could see a lot of kids growing up and enjoying this film. There was plenty of kids throughout my theater that were laughing. And I feel like, how can I take that away from kids? Or, you know, that's the demographic. You know what I mean? That those are the people who are going to watch this movie. It's for kids. It's for families. There was moms with their kids in the theaters laughing. And it was just a silly good time. After having watched the film, Haley and I looked at each other and we definitely felt that the critics were being super harsh on this film. It's nothing out of this world, you know, and I don't really think anybody should expect it to be. I feel like I knew what I was going to be getting walking into it. I feel like there could have been more development. I expected a little bit more development as far as the story and the characters. But on an overall level, I had a smile on my face. I enjoyed the characters. I enjoyed Robert Downey Jr. in the role. And I enjoyed the animals. I enjoyed the humor that came with it. The movie ended and I thought, that was cute. That was a nice time. Nothing crazy. Not necessarily something I'm jumping at the opportunity to buy on Blu-ray or watch again. But something that I definitely recommend for others. Definitely something I recommend for parents. If you're looking for something to go take your kids to go watch, that you guys can sit down and watch something silly for a couple hours. I think it's definitely a good option. I don't think it's a bad kids movie. I think my biggest gripes with the film, without a doubt, were just the lack of development of the side characters. There's a young boy that spends a lot of time, majority of the screen time, with Dolittle in this film, and his character just develops so quickly throughout the film without you really having time with his character. You don't ever really care about his character. You care enough, but you don't really care that much. And I just feel like his character just develops so quickly, and he was able to do things throughout the story that really didn't make any sense because they really don't expand upon any sort of development for this character. Then there's other characters that are introduced and you won't see again for another 15, 20, 30 minutes of screen time. Again, this is not a great film. This is not a fantastic film, but I had a good time with it. I think where it was strong, it was strong, and where it was weak, it was definitely weak. I think I'm about halfway with this movie. There was stuff I really liked about it. There was stuff that I really enjoyed, but there's stuff that I definitely was just not about, or some things that just felt lackluster. So yeah, guys, I think this is a film that's going to thrive on streaming services. I think that if you have something like AMC A-List, or you're a parent and you want to take your kids to just watch a silly film for the next couple hours, go watch it. But I don't think it's something I can recommend you rush out to theaters to see. I think it's a good time. I do recommend seeing it at some point and getting your own opinion in on it, but I would highly recommend just going and check out the trailers. If you can watch the trailer for this movie and you say, that's not for me, then it's not for you. And you know what? That's okay. If you can watch the trailer and say, you know, I'm kind of interested in that, you may go either way when you watch it. You know, you may not like it, you may like it. I don't think this is a film that I can just go ahead and flat out say, everybody's gonna love this, or you have to go see this, this is gonna be a great film. But I enjoyed it for what it was. I thought it was a silly, cute kids movie. And as somebody who still enjoys kids movies and can still also enjoy, you know, big adult films that make you think and have like deeper, darker themes in the movie, I still love being able to go and watch kids movies like this that are just silly, fun, and just kind of let your mind ramble and have a just good time throughout the film. And that's exactly what this movie was for me. Just a silly good time that was nothing crazy. Could have been developed a little bit better. Could have had a better story, but I enjoyed it for what it was. So yeah, guys, Dolittle. Leave your thoughts down below. Did you like this movie? Did you not like this movie? I'm definitely curious on your thoughts. If you have any spoilers that you want to talk about this movie, leave those comments down below and we can talk about those things. And I will see each and every single one of you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.